Hey everybody, welcome back again to Ken Tamplin Vocal Academy, where the proof is in the singing. Today, the proof is going to be in which songs have the greatest rip-offs, or plagiarisms as they're called. I put together quite a list here, and I want to go through these with you guys. Now, I'm sure I've missed quite a few, so if you have a song that you think I've missed, please put it in the comments section. Go ahead and put the link and you know what part of the song is the greatest rip-off. I'm going to do quite a few of these, and I've just put little short snippets, and I just want to get started. So I was pretty surprised because I forgot about some of these, how gnarly they really are. The first one is the Kinks' All Day and All Night, versus the Doors, Hello, I Love You. Let's just dive right in. Check this out. Girl, I want to be with you all of the time, all day, and all of the night. Hello, I love you, let me jump in your game. Pretty crazy, isn't it? Next up, now this is a pretty famous recent one, which is Tom Petty, I Won't Back Down versus Sam Smith, Stay With Me. So maybe not quite so recent, but enough. So here's the Tom Petty version. Check it out. Now, you might have a little tough time going through some of these because I took the snippets are pretty doggone short. Please feel free to check out the entire songs because it'll actually really surprise you. Now, this one was really fascinating to me because it's Coldplay. By the way, the Coldplay Viva La Vida is... they never actually won the lawsuit. Joe Satriani backed off of this. But Joe Satriani's If I Could Fly versus Coldplay's Viva La Vida. Check this out. Pretty doggone close, right? Next one is the New Seekers. I'd like to teach the world to sing in perfect harmony. That was an old Coca-Cola commercial, if I'm not mistaken, versus Oasis' Shaker Maker. Now, what people will do is they'll take a song and they'll plagiarize the heck out of it or rip it off, and they'll slow it down or speed it up or put it in a different key or try to change the groove a little bit. But a lot of these, they really didn't change much of anything. But let's check this out. Here we go. Pretty crazy, isn't it? Next one, Muddy Waters. You Need Love versus Led Zeppelin's Whole Lot of Love. Now, Led Zeppelin has gotten in trouble a couple of times for this. We're gonna get to the Stairway to Heaven one at the very, very end. But the first one will be Led Zeppelin. We just got a Whole Lot of Love. You know the song well, check it out. Baby, way down inside, woman, you need love. Pretty crazy, isn't it? Next one up, Huey Lewis in the News, I Want a New Drug versus Ray Parker Jr., Ghostbusters. Now, my understanding is that actually Huey Lewis was asked to do a song for Ghostbusters. He turned it down because he wanted to do Back to the Future, and the time frame, it didn't coincide with his ability to do it, so he wrote a Back to the Future song. Check this out. A new drug. Pretty gnarly, huh? This one is gonna blow your mind. Now, I find this kind of ironic because I actually like the Verve's Bittersweet Symphony. I wanted to do it myself. I wanted to sing it, and they blocked me because they own the song. Or do they? Listen to this. It is so close. They literally lifted an old Rolling Stones song and just redid it themselves for this. I kid you not, those are two different songs. Straight up, can you believe that? Holy cow. All right, not the cows are holy. Chuck Berry, You Can't Catch Me versus the Beatles Come Together. You're not gonna believe this one. Check this out. Here come a flat top, he was moving up with me. Can you believe that? Speaking of the Beatles or a Beatles member, Then you've got the chiffons, "He's So Fine," versus "My Sweet Lord" by George Harrison. Now, George did cop to it, and he did pay some royalties on this, but let's check out "My Sweet Lord" versus "He's So Fine." Check this out. Now, this next one is so conspicuously obvious that it's not even a contest, but it's the Hollies, "The Air That I Breathe" versus Radiohead's "Creep." Now, I know that this is pretty notorious. I said there'll be some that you guys will recognize. And yet, what's also interesting is that even though the Hollies let Radiohead slide, even though they just blatantly ripped it off, Radiohead turned around and I think sued Lana Del Rey for a version that she did of the song as well. Check this out. Now, if you guys know the song, some of these snippets are from different parts of the song, so it wasn't the exact same section, but there are other sections like it that are virtually identical. Now, we have Chuck Berry's "Sweet Little 16" versus the Beach Boys' "Surfing USA." Check this out. "Surfing USA." Mommy, please may I go? Such a sight to be. Now, if that isn't bad enough, poor Mark Ronson, Bruno Mars. I remember when I first heard Uptown Funk, and I noticed that there were quite a few songs that were involved in this song, and I think he got sued by 16 different artists over this. And I remember, you guys might remember old Dr. Demento, "Uptown Funk You Up, Bra Size 45. Bra Size 45, right? Well, it turns out there's actually more than one version of that kind of song, or that rhythm of that song, with the same phrasing and lyric, plus other added adventure features. Here we go. Leave it and watch. All right, sorry, we're already in the Killing Joke song of the 80s. Let me back this up just a skosh. Now, one of the things I found about this, the previous song that I used with Mark Ronson, is, you know, he was kind of notorious, or is kind of notorious, for lifting stuff. But believe it or not, so is Dua Lipa. I didn't actually put this here, but I mean, right? That's in excess. You've got... In fact, I just covered this song with one of my students here, and there's, in fact, she's got quite a few songs like this, but there's one in particular that has so much Donovan in it. I'm surprised, somewhere between Donovan and "Hey Mr. Tambourine." "Hey Mr. Tambourine Man, playing that song for me," right? Where do you recognize that melody from? Or "I'm on an island, baby," right? So we got a little bit of some Dua Lipa plagiarism ripoff. Anyway, all right, next one up. So Killing Joke song 80s versus Nirvana, "Come As You Are." Let's check this out. I might have backed it up a little too far. Okay, so here we go. After this. Cool. All right, well, that's pretty obvious if you ask me. Brian Pringle, "Take a Dive" versus Black Eyed Peas. I got a feeling. Check this out. I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. All right, now, everybody knows this one, so this is a no-brainer, but we had Queen and David Bowie, "Under Pressure," and you had Vanilla Ice, "Ice Ice Baby." Now, Vanilla Ice claims that he changed one note, so it made it a new song. Would you believe? I kid you not. He lost the lawsuit, by the way. Yes, in fact, those were two different songs. Now, the thing that is kind of interesting is sometimes, I'm going to back this up, songs may not be exactly the same, but they might have so much of a similar feel, and even the production value of the song itself is imitating another artist. Next up, we have One Direction. These guys were also notorious for doing this. Midnight Memories versus Def Leppard's Pour Some Sugar on Me. Check this out. You're not gonna believe this. Here it is. Now, next up, again, One Direction, Best Song Ever versus Baba O'Reilly, The Who. Now, this may not be so obvious, but again, the feel is so similar, and the intent, I think, is obvious. Check this out. All right, next up we have One Direction, Live While You're Young versus The Clash, Should I Stay or Should I Go? Now guys, you're not gonna believe this. I mean, it's one thing to kind of like be inspired by somebody, and it's another thing to do this. Check this out. After this, sorry. You know what I'm saying? Gosh. And we have Harry Styles, That's What Makes You Beautiful versus the movie Grease Summer Night. Check this out. Now we have Green Day's Warning and the Kinks Picture Book. Check this out. Now, we also have Green Day's Brain Stew versus Chicago's 25 or 6 to 4. Listen to this. It's pretty notorious if you ask me. Anyway, guys, now if I've missed somebody, please feel free to go ahead and put it in the description. I'd like to know. And without much further ado, I've got a few more of these. I want to see if you can guess who the artists are and who they imitated. So I'm going to let this play out while we just kind of chill out, while you're sitting there typing away in the comments sections to let me know who I missed. All right. Thank you so much for joining me, Ken Tampa Vocal Academy. And stick around for a few more of these because I have some more Led Zeppelin, etc. Check this out. Here we go.